sociable or good at talking to people, so they can't really, like, I don't want to say they can't really approach them and be like, hey, there's some holes in your testimony, motherfucker.
You do so think that, just... though. You're smart enough to know that there are holes and whatnot.
Oh, absolutely.
Now, whether or not you can bring that out in a delicate social manner is up to you. Is not in your purview, but you know who is? Jonathan, one of your more charismatic companions. Now, whether or not Jonathan wishes to pursue this line of interrogation is up to him. Jonathan, how do you feel about this whole thing?
So I've been thinking about it.
Investigator John.
And I'm realizing maybe I should stop playing good characters because I'm realizing I have to try and think like a good person and think about what should be done. And it's like, man, I kind of just want to move on. We got information.
Okay. Hurry to disclose it.
No.
It'll also be more helpful if we find out more in town.
More information.
Regarding this wizard, I don't think it's in her best interest to rat us out because she is technically an accomplice to the illegal things that we are doing.
And what I was also going to suggest is, like, you know, when we leave, I was going to have contact Asilme and then just, like, tell him everything. Well, not everything, but just tell him, be like, we got as much information as we can. You might be able to get more out of him than we could.
Also, regarding the bridge, I think that it's honestly for the best that we haven't encountered any of the Tarquins. Mm-hmm. Because it means that we've made it through here, we found a bunch of information, and the people that guard this bridge don't know shit about it.
Yeah.
Moments to climb up the tower. Kind of continue going up. Eventually, you will go through the small corridor leading up the stairs, and you can see Alarie who scrolling through pages of her spell tome. Goes, had a good time down there.
Yeah.
B's just gonna go up the stairs to the second floor of the tower.
Gotcha.
Do you know of the ruined tower on Barkhar's Bridge, the one that's all singed and such?
The westernmost tower.
Yes, we did some investigative work here, and Renee was able to find out that this was where, this tower was where, the sniper had fired, shot and fired and killed the politicians, or the one politician. And upon further investigation, there was a ladder leading further down the tower, and it looks like, if it was as if it was put in after the bridge was constructed. So someone must have had deep knowledge of the bridge. But the most alarming thing was that the ladder was a portal to the Grim Hollow. I've been thinking about it for a bit now. You think our political influence, do you think it could be of Kulara?
He was my first suspect, ironically enough. But, no, I do not think, in my personal judgment, I do not think it is Mayor Iron. He is far too reserved and far too timid to do such a thing.
I see. Well, that's, oh, before I forget, and B's gonna, as, like, while they're calling, B's just gonna text him the picture that they took of the bodies and say, at the bottom of the ladder, there were these bodies, and it was it was some form of ritual that I'm assuming Yarislav was doing our investigation here. Yarislav also appears to be very, at least either him or his accomplice seems very well versed in alchemy. Whoever it was able to create a very powerful mage bane.
Mage bane is quite short in the supply. That is a powerful substance. I will duly note this.
Whoever our alchemist is, they must be, they must have influence somewhere to get the ingredients necessary to make it.
It makes me suspect that this Yaroslav is not the alchemist, simply the purveyor or scout. There may be a third suspect. Not the killer, not the shooter, perhaps, but the alchemist. Perhaps the supplier and the creator for the Mage Bane. Just my conjecture, but something to think on.
It's something I'll keep note of it, but it's, that's everything we found.
Good work, B. You've done me proud. Let the others know that they've done good work. If there's anything else, please wrap up what you must do at Valkos. And when you're finished, please come down to the clinic. Understood?
Yes, absolutely. We're gonna try and talk to that PI and the Knights of Dido. And I believe we're heading back down to Zirkel.
Good. I'll talk to you later, then.
Goodbye, Isilne. Bone Amulet of Quetzalcoatl? In Aztlan, these bone amulets, often carved from deceased drake or serpent bones, is immaculately combined and crafted. Initiates often track down a dangerous serpent and bring its remains to a bone shaper, who then hands it back to the hunter. Carrying such an amulet notifies others of one's high station within the cult of Quetzalcoatl. And you found this in the dresser, Farah.
She nods. It must mean of something quite significant, but I suppose when they were running away or retreating elsewhere, they forgot about it.
This is a good find, Farah. This is... Narrows things down a bit.
I would say go to the cafe, because I doubt the PI is just gonna...
be out in the open.
Renee will turn to the group, and he will say, I've just received a message from our friend Caspian. He says that he's arranged a meeting for us at Kuro's Cafe. Now, I know we didn't necessarily have the greatest time last time we were here in Cularo and at that particular place, but hopefully things will be a little more quiet this time.
Well, for our sake, let's hope for that.
Are you suggesting we go meet up and meet at Kuro's now?
Skeleton?
A wild Satomi appears.
Oh, Satomi Suisegi! He's so cool!
he approaches you. The shooting.
Who?
All of you.
Party or... Oh, okay.
The collective you.
The collective.
Okay.
You, plural. And, as he does, you know, he's got his cloak wrapped up all over his body, and he looks at you, Jonathan, and he goes, I have a letter just for you.
For me, Jacob Reed?
No, Sir Jonathan Tyes.
Alright, yeah, give me that.
Probably head up there, at least by myself, when we get back to the Dark Hallets. Thank you for telling us, Satomi.
Of course. And, kind of looks up. It is, I pray for better news for the future for all of us here. He kind of looks up over at the blimps of Cularo, and he will say, right, God's protect you all.
And he will... God protect you, Satomi. Oh, and just for the record...
He turns around.
You were right when you were arguing with, Nalsian the other day.
He'll cock a smirk. He'll turn around. He'll smile, and he'll make his way.
And walks off into the sunset.
flute instrument. Just as I understand, and I hope I do not come across as quite brazen, but I understand two of your party members have been implicated loosely within the assassination, an attempted assassination of our three mayoral candidates. Just know that I will not judge you. On that basis, but I am keeping that in mind as we move forward with this conversation.
It's understandable.
Yes, you would be remiss if you did not. I understand that weighing on your mind in this moment, but I assure you that my colleagues here, they were simply victims of circumstance. They happened to find themselves in the wrong place at the wrong time, and as they attempted to help after the attempt, they were quickly thrown under the bus. It's A shame, really. Shall we say complicated situation. But I did have a specific question. You see, we've been investigating something that's quite startling. It would appear that there is someone, and we've been unable to find any clues as of yet as to who it might be, in the Cularan government who is a cultist.
A cultist to what god?
I shan't say his name, but he is a leader of a certain yellow variety.
She immediately takes a moment and then immediately puts the two
appears
together.
That he was a former yellow cultist himself, but had given up the whole cult activity thing in order to pursue his business relations. But he was framed. We went to his home. We found evidence that he was a yellow cultist member, but something was off about it. We came to the conclusion that this evidence, it wasn't his doing. It didn't make sense. It was almost as if someone had broken into his house and set these things up.
Which isn't out of the question. His door was not very secure at the moment.
He hires a Josian detective, and now he hires Lusanian mercenaries. It appears our mayor is more fond of outsiders than relying on us, but perhaps that says something about us than him.
I think it means, and this is just a theory, of course, but it strikes me that he's all of a sudden bringing in all of this outside help. Perhaps he's discovered something. Perhaps something that, if word were to get out to any locals, would shake the area down to its core. I mean, that would be the only reason to bring in, shall we say, the apolitical windmill dragons. They fight only for glory. So if the mayor has found something for them to pursue, then it must be something big.
Odd as it may seem, we have to take what we can get in terms of the information we are being brought forward. I appreciate all of the work that all of you have been putting forth. I understand some of you are not even native to the city, but I appreciate the help nonetheless.
Of course, and we appreciate you coming to meet us and hearing us out, and of course any results that may come from your efforts. They are in dire need. We've been pursuing this, what seems like by ourselves for quite some time now. It's a good feeling to have others involved.
With the many connections and twists and turns that seems to be going, having multiple eyes looking into all these things would certainly help.
She nods. It's a genuine smile, one that says thanks in more ways than she can deliver with words. She says, "I greatly appreciate all the work that you have been doing, even under the scrutiny of the Cularan government. That being said," and she will pull out a slip of parchment. She will write down her signature, and she will hand it to you, Renee, and she says, "Get the signature of Lord Fabian Tarquin. That will be enough to give you legitimacy to rid all of you of any suspicions of your involvement in the assassination."
Is getting involved in this not going to put you in a negative
those folks,
way?
Do we, Faradir?
She looks at Faradir. Faradir's spacing out, Cassandra's spacing out.
Huh?
She goes, right. Well, if there's nothing else. And she will stand up from her. She'll, like, slide back her chair. She'll stand up and dust off her long robe.
I will stand up as well, and I will kind of bow and say thank you.
She'll actually reach out for a handshake for you, Renee.
Oh, shit. I will return said handshake.
She will smile once again and say, thank you. And she will slide in her chair. She will say, Melkart protect you all. Good luck on the investigation ahead. And she will turn around. She will open the door and close it.
No, when it's not a normal worm. I feel like when I ask the question, some get the wrong idea, but you'll know it when you see it.
It'll be aberrant in nature, I suppose.
Aye.
Gotcha. All right. I'll bust out the bestiary and see if anything I find it will match up, but I appreciate the heads up, truly. And he'll take his leave. He'll begin to walk out of the cafe. He'll throw like a coin purse at Kuro, who's just kind of like mumbling. He's just like, this is too much. And Caspian's already gone by that point.
Oh, I didn't even think about the fact Kuro is also hearing all of this.
Oh no, he's too far away. Like, you guys.
Okay.
You guys are like over here. He's like at the counter.
Oh, the too much is in response to the coins. I thought you meant he was hearing all of this and having mental breakdown.
No.
The city's falling apart. I gotta get out. Ooh, it's getting a little late. So,
Faradir, if you want to go to that,
he'll dust himself off and be like, "Well, I've got some business to attend to."
Just go to the bordello. It's okay.
Faradir, I think it's safe to say that with the work that you've put in, you've earned it. Go have some fun.
Just if something bad happens.
He has Bon Jovi.
Best of luck.
Man. Jeez, guys, this is really nice of you. But yes, I'll enjoy myself.
As some would say,
do y'all want to come with?
No, we have to focus on the mission.
No, I think that it's quite all right. As some would put it, go and get your freak on. Need someone to throw some weight around, you know where to call me.
That's true. Having a Centurion on speed dial will probably be helpful.
And if need be, I will drop everything and I'll come straight there. Mm. Just let me know.
It's appreciated.
In that case, B, do you wish to put your mask back on?
Oh, that's true. We're not really. Oh, but I don't have my. Shit. I didn't bring another set of clothes. I'd be in the crop top and like short pants.
Crop with a gas top, mask. Short shorts and gas mask.
It wouldn't be worth it, bro.
Almost like bro, a it's... gimp out. It's almost like a gimp outfit.
I mean, have you seen the replies on four panel dude?
Oh. Trust me, they know and they are unhappy.
They think it's worse.
Dude, the only fashion B cares about is that their hair remains soft and smells nice. And thank God for prestidigitation.
Oh yeah, I still stink.
Oh, that can be alleviated.
Yeah, I think I'm still technically covered in zombie that blew up in my face.
I think you guys would have prestidigitized each other before you spoke to them.
Yeah, no, we're good.
Thank God for that.
But good luck with them. The PI, Renee. Well, I'll text you if anything comes up with the Tarquin.
All right. Best of luck.
As to you. Jinx.
I believe that constitutes a soda. And then he walks away.
Yeah, no, I'm just staring at you, B, after I saw
the freaking Bateman stare. It's like, where's my soda?
I'm confused. Where is this going?
Are you not familiar? It's an old, like, children's game.
I didn't have friends growing up, so no.
Oh, I apologize.
I didn't have a childhood.
I think I have to... just leave.
He said,
I gotta go.
I should go.
Someone else, like a lizard folk man, who's like clearly like some sort of hunter from outside, who's just walking. He's like, yeah, I know. I saw him around, you know, the corner, across the street. So you follow these threads, and eventually you do find the man himself after about 10 minutes of searching. That is how fast you got this done.
I may have rolled a natural 20, bro.
You see the man in question, like a khaki colored trench coat, very well kept short black hair, pale, well kept skin. Clearly a man who moisturizes and takes care of himself. He appears to be. He appears to be just drinking like a bottle of water, and kind of looking out to like the sky and whatnot, almost absentmindedly.
Indeed, it's still unfortunate that that's the way that people recognize me. But hopefully...
I can assure you that nothing of negativity has been spread about your name up here, at least.
That's reassuring. But more to the point, it's a pleasure to actually get to meet you. I've heard that you've been investigating the whereabouts of the Duke and some other things. I was wondering if perhaps you'd be willing to talk to me about some of these things. I've been conducting my own investigation, as you can imagine, but it's sometimes good to speak to others about these things. At least some of these prophecies seem to line up particularly, well, shockingly well with current events. Specifically, my question is in regards to the noblewoman in this tale. I have been hesitant, shall we say, to tell others about this, but well, perhaps you as an investigator have come to your own conclusions on this matter, but I believe that this noblewoman is perhaps a member of a cult. This woman is perhaps of some stature here in the upper city. I was wondering if you've come across anything regarding this.
Women, I've searched for several.
Yeah, I see where you're going.
And well, one stood out, mainly due to her excitement. Normally, it is natural for mothers to be excited about the prospects of becoming a mother, but I believe this one was very excited about the prospect of the future she wanted to have with her lover. And she has not been very forthcoming about who her lover is.
I see.
Mr. Guillaume, what I'm about to share with you, it must be kept wrapped between your party members and, for now, myself. I leave it up to you. At your own discretion, at your own agency, who you wish to reveal this information to. I will leave that responsibility to you. You are a man of high station and high renown. I will respect your judgment in either case. And he pulls out a file. I can share further information if need be, if you are willing to exchange contact information.
Yes, of course. And I'll hand over my information. There was another question I wanted to ask you about your investigation. I've been told that you've been somewhat hesitant to speak to any local officials investigating this matter. Is there any particular reason for this? I mean, you seem to be quite forthcoming with me. Is that simply because I'm an outsider? Are you worried that those with certain political leanings or ties to the area would be shocked with some of this information? And in talks with him. You've been in contact with him, have you not?
Very limited. He has very little time for me. He is too consumed in his bureaucracy. But from what we have spoken, he trusts that I must gather sufficient evidence. He has left that what that constitutes, he has left that quite abstract. But I understand what he wants.
I'm sure you've heard the rumblings that he's bringing in windmill dragons. I was wondering if, speaking to you, he may have gleaned some information about that. Does he, or do you, believe you have any, shall we say, found out any motivations as to why he's doing this? I mean, I have my assumptions, of course, but they're nothing more than that. First, that you be careful in dealing with these individuals if you even attempt to deal with them at all. Steering clear of them and just watching them is perhaps your best bet, but
I have been relying on this one Aussie man named Jasper Weaving. I have been paying him enough information to keep me informed, but not as well informed as you have been, although I suppose he's trying to rip me off. But what you have been telling me has been quite enlightening. I will look into these rabbit holes and I will investigate.
I understand your apprehension in going to the lower city, but perhaps
it may be necessary.
Yes. But that is all for now. Thank you again.
Of course. Take care, Mr. Guillaume.
Yes, you take care as well. Have a nice day.
And he'll wave you goodbye, and he'll kind of look both directions and then casually walk away to almost seem as though you guys were just having a conversation, nothing too serious. As you are, you see the bordello. It's not that far away. It's on the horizon. You got your adrenaline pumping. You know, you got
It's time.
It's time to set sail, even. And as you do so, you know, you get your mojo flowing. You get interrupted with a call.
Oh no!
Oh, the fuck's calling me?
I'm gonna get water.
Go for it. It is from Alice. Do you pick up?
God damn it. I imagine I'm like so in the zone that it like jump scares me.
Oh, absolutely. Like, and you got some of the people who are in the streets also get jump scared because they see you and Bon Jovi walking down the street.
I forgot I had my shit on max volume. You stay. Shit. Oh, God. You take Bones and head to the clinic. Alright?
You sure? You sure? Yeah. We're fine staying here if need be. I don't think there's anyone around.
Go to the clinic. I don't want to chance anything. You take him, head to the clinic. I'll figure this out.
The dragon turtle, she's fine. She doesn't look like she's been hurt.
Alright. Yeah, you just take him, head to the clinic, I'll sort this out.
Okay, I'll see you soon?
Yeah, I'll be around when I can.
Okay, and she hangs up. Bottle and he'll pour some into a second tankard, and I'll hand it to you, John.
Hell yeah.
And he'll pour some for himself, and then he'll kind of raise it up and he'll say, Turazanur, as champions, and the pink-haired allies to his champions.
I can drink to that.
And he'll kind of slam your tankard, and he'll start chugging it.
Hell yeah, I'll drink to that.
And then after a bit, it goes, ooh, that is cold. And also he'll put the tankard down delicately. Oh, yeah. But if there's anything else, then he goes,
no, I think that's all we had to trouble you with.
Ah, it was no trouble. Please, take care, and God's be with you.
out there with you?
I got good old Captain here with me also.
Well, we're done here. One moment. B.
Yes.
Faradir is... Something happened. He's caught up in something.
What? Can he not get it up?
No, I don't believe it's related to the bordello.
Oh.
He's heading down to the docks. It sounds pretty bad. Since we're done here, and you have the signature, do you want to meet up with... Wait, actually, hold on. And I'll put the phone back up. Goes, are you with Renee, or is he still looking for the investigator?
I'm with Renee by this point, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got him right here.
All right, in that case, we'll meet you up at the docks.
All right, see ya.
And I'll hang up.
This cannot be. How could someone attack a ship full of your crew?
Well, clearly someone has it for Mr. Hafsvada, or it's whoever we're working against trying to send a message to us.
This cannot...
If they're powerful enough to take out nearly all of Faradir's crew, safe to assume they're at least like one powerful individual or a powerful group of people.
No, we cannot assume it was one person.
No.
This cannot be a coincidence. Faradir's ship is large. Its crew complement equally so. We have to see what remains of the ship.
We have to. My instincts are telling me that it could be linked to the three individuals that we encountered before we left Kulara that one night.
You see a mess on board. Several of your crew members who are dead here or destroyed. They have been...
Calcio!
They have been... There are bullet holes. There are claw marks. There are slashes. The ship itself is intact to an extent. Faradir, there is a letter that is the last grasp that Calcium has. It's almost as if he was holding on to it in his final moments.
Get up.
Alright, go ahead and place it in your inventory.
My god.
Oh, I have to loot Calcium. Fuck.
I'm so sorry, friend. it's not quite cracked yet, but it's certainly dry.
I want to. This is what I want to do, Percy. I'm going to take four of my bolts for my syringes, and I'm going to get a sample of each of the spots.
Okay.
And I'm going to add it to. I'm gonna remove four bolts and add four separate charges to their.
Yeah, please
for
do.
for the syringes. Yeah.
So that is what B's gonna spend a good amount of time doing. Jonathan, anything you wanted to do?
Faradir, how are you?
Not great.
Are not people you know, of course. They meant a good deal to Faradir, and they've been all wiped. This was for all intents and purposes, as far as you understand it, a intended military attack, or organized front. On this ship, someone was planning this out. This did not seem like a spur of the moment.
Renee, as he's like clenching his fists, he looks to John and Faradir, and he just says, "This cannot stand. Somebody knew what they were doing here. This is a targeted attack. Somebody that we are investigating is responsible for this.
Come, everyone, come around. The letter. My ears to varying degrees told your old kind, outstanding members of your community. I'm informed of your dealings with Dr. Asume and your pledge to help Dr. Blackwell in the clinic. This is all well and good. Continue serving the citizens as Arkel, but do not search for me if you value your safety. Nothing against you personally, but I need to demonstrate the level of power I command with this act of violence on Captain Hasvada's vessel. Do not fret the Dragon Turtle as well. She's been very kind, and we spoke at length. I, as Duke of the Deep, feel responsibility to my city. We've suffered for too long. Political, cultural, linguistic history going beyond our years. This is none of your business. You should leave and stop playing at heroics. It will only leave you and your loved ones exposed to potential harm. Not of my own making, but of other actors, be they the Cularan or Zarkelan clans and organizations. May the gods of Salt and Brine grant you safe passage in such uncertain times. The Duke of the Deep.
I've taken samples of all the blood that, of the blood splashes. I'm gonna... You guys can continue your investigation in Zarkel. I'm gonna remain at the clinic and see if I can get anything from the blood samples.
Forensic work? Not a bad idea.
Not the first time I've had to do something like this.
The Duke himself. I will hand you the letter.
I'm gonna look over the letter. I'm gonna bring it up in chat.
Holy shit.
Notice. For right now, I'm not gonna question how he knows my actual name, but... I'm going to inform Dr. Asome. I'm going to go inform Dr. Asome of what's happened here and the contents of this letter, if you guys don't mind.
I'll just nod.
Faridir, I'm sorry for your loss.
We'll just kind of like wave a hand at you.
Yeah.
Pat him on the back, and he's gonna lean on like the side. And just look out over the ocean. The ocean.
And as you do so, kind of think back to the fjords of your homeland that you have not returned to in quite some time. And you think back to your mother, who is likely participating in, you know, manual labor at her farm. You also think about the anger that rolls inside you like a maelstrom, and you think about the last bit of words the Duke of the Deep has left you. May the gods of Salt and Brine grant you safe passage. It's almost demeaning. Might not be intended to come across that way, but it certainly feels like it.
Because I imagine this dude knew so much about us, he would probably know that Theater had a deep friendship with Calcium.
I will say from your earlier role, I'll tell you, his rib cage appears to be three separate holes that's been left in his rib cage. Like there was an upward attack into his rib cage, like thrust upward. And it cracked, like, in three places, like, three spaced-out places in his ribcage.
Evenly spaced out?
Evenly spaced out.
Trident.
Correct.
I'm on with you, Faradir. I do. I must say, I think I speak for all of us when I say that if the Duke thinks... this act of cowardice, of malice, will hinder our efforts in any way, will keep us from pursuing him, I think he's dead wrong. If anything, he's achieved the opposite of his goals. He's only steeled my resolve personally to find him and bring him to justice. And again, you see an anger in Guillaume's eyes that you haven't seen since after the terrorist attack. I I will say my motivation has taken an impact with this, but my resolve, my will, my determination, it shall prosper. It shall persevere. And again, I'm sorry, Faradir. I'm sorry that this is what the fruits of our labor have brought you. And he kind of just sits down on the ledge.
It's a lie.
Said hooves.
I heard hooves. I think I heard some flying creature. I heard the rushing of wind, you know. I thought the dragon turtle was gonna lose her shit, but she started to calm down after a little bit. It was weird. I thought she'd make it, but she stayed calm.
How long this all last?
Maybe like, I don't know, man. Time went by fast. Maybe like 30 minutes.
This is about a couple hours ago.
He nods.
Sound like any of them got hurt? Other than, well, more than just a scratch or two.
Hid and didn't see anything. You seem to know a lot about the assailants.
I only saw what I saw on the horizon, man. And then I heard the shots fire. I was like, oh, maybe my mind's fucking with me. I don't know. Like, when you clean the deck, do you expect a black dragon to start flying around?
I'm inclined to believe you for now, but the fact that you are the only remaining survivor is, needless to say, suspicious.
Well, he's not officially part of the crew. With how much knowledge the Duke seemed to have on all of us, maybe he wasn't looking for this fellow.
The Duke? The Duke of the Deep? You for real?
As real as it gets.
Fuck, man. I just wanted a good job, man.
Dude, this guy can't catch a fucking break, dude. This poor dude.
Percy, this brings up an interesting question. Is there any damage?
Listen, I want to be as innocent. I want to be clear, you know, of any suspicions, man. I want to help if I can. I know I was useless. I'm not good in a fight, man. I know it doesn't look good that I'm the only survivor here. Well, I mean, Mr. Bones was good. He's a good fellow. I hope he's all right.
It's quite all right. Like I said, you've been helpful, and you haven't been deceitful thus far. I'm sure that if we corroborate your story, that all will be forgiven.
Percy?
What's up?
Would Damien have mentioned what type of dragon his mom is?
He did tell you.
What type of dragon was she?
A black dragon.
Guess we're off to kill Damien's mom.
Yep, that's what that's what I knew it. I fucking knew it.
He'll nod, and he'll pick up the broom. He'll pick up the mop, and then he'll go down to the deck and grab a broom as well and some cleaning materials.
And I'm gonna go to the rowboat.
Gotcha.
Now we're going straight to Zarkel, or just are we having to go back to the harbor and then go to Zarkel via the bridge? Or can we just go straight to Zarkel?
There is the harbor on the Zarkelan side. You don't have to go back to the Cularan side. Because you guys sailed here from Cularo.
Yeah.
I'm going straight to the clinic is where I'm going.
Gotcha.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Yeah, I think that's...
Once we get back into radio wave presence, I would like to... I'm going to text Damien to meet me at the clinic.
Like nudging up against slightly.
My sensing anything?
She seems to be calmed by your presence. She seems to have missed you.
He'll kind of nod and just, like, pet her on the side of the head.
As you do so, you get the feeling she feels partially guilty about what had happened.
He'll look and he'll nod again and pet her reassuringly, so as to say, you know, it's not your fault. Don't worry about it.
Doctor, the note also mentioned that it knows about our connection with this clinic.
Correct.
What should we?
We move as usual. What more can be done?
What if they target the clinic next? What do we do?
Their forces, from what we saw, were quite strong. They took out the crew, and we had one witness who claimed to have saw a black dragon.
Black dragon, you say?
Specifically, we call them the Xeno Queen of Zarkar. And if they're aligning themselves with the Duke of the Deep, then that's a
dangerous foe.
Yeah, that's the best way to put it.
Outnumbered. There are no warriors in this clinic. Dr. Blackwell is trained with self-defense, but she is no warrior. And the secretaries are just civilians. There is zero advantages to be had from attacking this place. It would only actually garner further hatred for Zilla. If the clinic was praised within the letter, and they say we're doing good here, it makes no sense for them to attack us. So please rest well, knowing that.
Time will tell, Doctor.
And if they do attack, I will be waiting here for them.
That gives me some form of comfort.
I'll rest, but I'm not happy about it.
I'm not happy about it either, but...
we can reconvene tomorrow.
He'll reach up. He'll put a hand on your forearm, kind of like grasping at your wrist and your hand, and he'll say, "Captain, don't feel too down. You still got it."
Yeah. Thanks. I'll put my hand on top of his hand,
and he forcibly creases his skull to form a smile.
Now that's impressive.
And he goes, "Right, I'm gonna be relaxing here for a bit. You get some rest, Captain."
Yeah. I'll talk to you in the morning, man.
Sounds good to me.
And he'll leave and close the curtain behind him.
She'll approach. She'll give you a hug. She kind of pats you on the back. She goes, "Hey, can't have the captain look too sullen, okay?"
Yeah, I guess not. And he'll reciprocate the hug.
And she'll remain hugging you for a moment. And then she'll exit the hug. She'll lightly slap you. And she'll say, "All right, get some rest."
Yeah, gotta find a place to do that first, but...
just head to the Drunken Oath.
Yeah. Probably.
Have a good night, Faradir.
Yeah. Yeah, you too.
The Duke had some sort of information on me, and he knew my actual name. So, we're gonna have to... yeah, and that's... he knew some stuff about Jonathan, too, but... I don't want to sound selfish, but I'm primarily concerned about how he knows anything about me, because the only two people I've ever told were, Dr. Blackwin and Silme.
No, I don't think it could be either of them.
No, which only leads back to the only other person it could have been, and that person being my brother. Who?
You have a brother?
Yes, I have a... I should preface, I'm from Fredonia. I'm from Albuquerque.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry.
I did. Yes, my,
in New Mexico.
Yeah. Dude, Hunter, making BL is like, I want to make an alchemist from New Mexico. Specifically Albuquerque. I think that'd be funny. I'm a successful one at that, too, but...
And you're vegetarian.
I know.
Isn't it like that? What is that? Like irony?
Irony, comedic, it's... Eh.
Tragic.
We'll go with all three. But my brother, Ronnie, he helped me. He took what little money he had and sent me on my way to Kulara with enough funds to take the entrance exam to Awan University.
Oh,
and
okay.
Got wrapped up and spent a couple of years there doing studies and got wrapped up into some unfortunate things, and that was all about 5 years ago.
Okay. How old are you?
Currently I'm 23.
Oh. Kind of nods.
I know. I don't even know if he uses the same phone number.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if I could ever do that, you know, like, being away from family or friends for that long.
Well, I guess it's all a matter of upbringing. I mean, given all this, I probably should. Maybe I should talk to him again. I'm sure news got back about the scandal in Cularo, and I don't even know if he would want to talk to me.
Hey, don't assume the worst. Maybe if he's willing to get you here, I don't see why he would, you know, start disliking you all of a sudden. Wouldn't make any sense to me. If that's the case, I'll beat him up.
Hey. That'd be a funny sight to see.
Yeah, big old toothy grin at your, after hearing you laugh. He's clearly trying his best to cheer you up.
I don't really have any other way to put it. I'm not too well versed in the subject, but do you always do it in our bedroom?
She kind of looks at Davian, and Davian, he's just kind of chewing. He's in bliss. He's enjoying the food. And she goes, well, it's not like we can go to his place.
Well, I'm sure you do, but do you at least wash the sheets after?
Yeah, B.
Look, I'm taking precautions, okay?
I'm not, you, I feel offended. Here, grab me seconds.
Yeah, okay. He's gonna get up and... I guess, like, while grabbing seconds, he's gonna look at the two of them and just kind of stare at them for a bit. Which is in character for B2, because they don't know how to wear this either. Well, Desiree, Damien had mentioned your, I guess, feelings or attraction for to me. What nature is your attraction? Is it, I guess, more sexual or romantic?
Both. I mean, I thought it was being pretty obvious. Like, I guess you're so dense. You didn't get it? Which I love about you, but, like, come on.
Well, sorry, first of all.
Damien, who's chewing blissfully, she's like, this is good food. Desiree has a type.
I see. You don't say queer. What the fuck do you mean queer?
Do you have like any built up stress or anything like that?
Whoa.
I mean, at the moment, I guess I am pretty stressed.
You see Damien and Desiree both look at each other. There's like a devilish smile on both of their faces.
I guess what I'm saying is, regardless of how the rest of tonight goes, I can't say how you two have been in more relationships than I, so, I guess I'll be eager to learn from the both of you.
You see, Damon's pogging.
And...
B, make a fortitude check.
Oh. Luckily for me, I'm a marshal. Five. My... Is this versus against poison?
No.
Wait, what's the DC? What'd you say?
I said B has to roll fortitude with a minus five.
Oh, with a minus five. Oh, true. She do be first timer.
Against two Lord. Experience, it's over.
It's Jawadi, though.
It's never been so.
I'm sorry, it's what, Malik? You know, dude, you know my characters in sex checks, dude.
Honestly, incredible.
Dude. I will just say, it's so funny because Damien, he's already gone, like, he's already taken off his shirt and everything. He's got a working class bod, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's got a little bit of hair on his chest, just a little bit. I'll say, Desiree will start pointing to you her favorite spots on his body. And,
this is peak.
And I guess B will at primal instincts take over and start using their fingers and to navigate his, all of his different crevices.
Dude, his constructed worker's body.
Yeah.
Like a bear or something?
I don't know if I classify Damien as a bear, but...
No, not at all.
No. No, I just, I didn't sleep well last night.
Raccoon?
No, just didn't have time to properly, do my hair this morning. I rushed out as soon as I realized what time it was.
Monica looks at you and says, "What's gotten you all so worked up?"
I'm usually not late, and I don't know.
Right, but what's caused you to be so late?
It's the mission. It's,
Right.
Been real taxing. It's been real taxing on me, I suppose.
Gotcha.
Hopefully this is a...
Is that a hickey?
I don't know what that is, and there's... actually gonna go to the bathroom to see if they can do something about it.
Finished. Please return to the, kind of leans in.
Right! Yeah, of course, I just got
a hand on your shoulder. Everything okay? Slowly turns you around.
Gonna try and resist a little bit, be like, I'm perfectly fine, Dr. Silme, I just need to run to the restroom.
Kind of leans in, looking over, goes, I see. Interesting, you must have had a fun night.
I'm sorry. I know you said to get a good rest, but,
I'm most certain you've had a good rest.
I'm feeling a little fatigued, so I'm going to try and spruce myself up.
I'm sure you do. Please do.
I'm gonna spruce myself up. Somebody's gonna hear a screaming on the other end of the door.
calls over for Faradir and John.
And hand it to him and say, it's likely that we're also dealing with someone that could also potentially be a cultist of Quetzalcoatl. And with...
Remind me again, B, what was the rifle that was used to kill?
It was Aslan? Azatlan?
Aztlan?
Aztlan?
Something like that.
It was an Aztlan rifle, which...
The location of the rifle matches up. With where followers of this god would be.
That's correct. I guess in my own delirious state, I forgot to hand this over to you last night, so I...
Well, it's a good thing you did not break it with all your ruckus.
Can we please move on?
Yeah, you didn't catch any fluids on that, did you?
He kind of inspects it and he goes, I don't see anything on here.
I did not bring my bag into my...
that's beside the point.
Contaminated then.
We may need to inspect your bedroom if it isn't contaminated after all.
I doubt it.
Damn. So you did this in your home, huh?
Again, can we please?
Yes. Damien had to have been at least
Damien
one.
For sure.
Dr. Asilme!
Is it your roommate?
Oh, the roommate as well, absolutely. I can see there are two different sized lip patterns on the neck.
Bro is doing like a Sherlock Holmes investigation going, that matches up with Desiree's mouth.
the remainder of the cum shot was spontaneous.
It's like L.A. Noir when you're investigating a body and you pick it up and you rotate it and then it plays the jingling.
Ravaged.
Good lord.
One moment, please, and B's gonna go to the, he's gonna go to the corner and, sneakily, pull up there just to see, a little bit of their thigh. Is there the Damien bite?
Yes.
Jesus.
B will look to you, Faradir, and say, yes, like an enamel.
Yeah? What, you got bite marks down there? What are you looking at?
It was hazy last night. I was just double checking.
What matters is you had a fun and enjoyable experience, right?
I relieved a good bit of my stress.
Here's that's hoping.
Good. She'll smile and she'll reach down, give you a hug, and she'll say, "We'll be at the clinic. Be fine. We'll be just fine." Dr. Silme and the rest of us, I shall exhale the hug. We're looking after each other. Look after your companions, okay?
Yeah, I'll be sure to. Truth be told, I mean, my biggest concern is you and everyone else here at the clinic, but...
Do not fret about me. Focus on the path ahead and helping your friends.
Right, thank you again, Dr. Blackwell.
Of course. And I will keep you all notified of anything that happens at the clinic or if anything is in need of your notice. Understood?
Of course. Thank you. Hold on. Can I get my help?
I looked at the token at the right, and my first thought was, his hair looks softer in that one.
Fruity!
Clip it, clip it, clip it, clip it, clip it.
No!